from heaven's throne, acquainted with our sorrow, to trade the debt we owe, your suffering for our freedom. My name upon your heart, my shame upon your shoulders, the power of sin undone, the cross for my salvation. The there is no greater love. The Savior lifted up. There is no greater love. No, there is no greater.
Lord sings.
When I see the blood, when I see the blood, when I see the blood, I will pass over you. Christ our Redeemer died on the cross, died for the sinner, paid all his dues. All who receive him need never fear. I will pass over you. When I see the blood, see the blood. When I see the blood, see the blood. When I see the blood, see the blood. I will pass over you.
God bless you, saints. Happy Passover, saints. Giving honor to God and to all the saints on this joyous night, it is the Lord's Passover. Tonight is a night we must remember. It's a sacred time appointed by the Lord. We didn't set it up. We didn't choose the day. We didn't choose the month. Neither did we choose the time of day. This was appointed before we were born, not even the time before our grandparents and our parents were born. It was appointed by the Lord. Thou shalt therefore keep the ordinance in his season, Exodus 13 says, in his season, from year to year, from year to year, in his season. So the word that comes to my mind tonight is freedom. Tonight we celebrate freedom. We know that our Redeemer lives. Surely he has seen our affliction and heard our cries, and he know our sorrows. Tonight we celebrate redemption through the blood of Jesus Christ. The Bible says, on this night, Pharaoh called for Moses and Aaron and said, get them thee from among me, you and your people, and the children of Israel, and go and serve the Lord. And we magnify God tonight, for the Redeemer liveth, our Redeemer liveth. And he said, get out of Egypt. And when they got to the Red Sea, the water was in front of them, and Pharaoh was behind them. And they couldn't move forward, and they surely didn't want to go backward. Moses told them, fear ye not, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. The Egyptians you see today, you will see no more. Salvation of the Lord. We know we're not doing this because they came out of Egypt, but because the Bible says, as often as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, ye do show forth the Lord's death till he come. It is the Lord's Passover. It is for the Lord. It is for the Lord. Sacrifices were offered continually, year after year, but none of those sacrifices could make us perfect. Oh, but the blood of Jesus. Oh, but the Lamb of God. Blood like no other. The precious Lamb of God. Blood that freed us from dead works to serve the living God. Freed us from sin. Freed us from fear. Freed us from doubt. Freed us from self-destruction. Freed us from hatred and bitterness. Freedom from things we messed up even on our own selves. Freedom from the trouble that we got our own selves in. Oh, but the blood of Jesus. The blood of animals couldn't do anything. Couldn't do it. But the blood of Jesus could free us from sin. It could free us from sin. Ephesians 2:2-5 says, wherein in time past ye walked according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit that now worketh in the children of obedience. But we thank God that we are the children of disobedience, the children that working in the spirit of the children of disobedience. But we thank God that we are the children of obedience, among who also we all had our conversation in times past in the lust of our flesh, fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind, and were by nature the children of wrath, even as others. But God, who is rich in mercy, for his great love toward wherewith he loved us, even when we were dead in sin, sin had us bound, even when we were dead in sin, and sin had us bound, hath quickened us together with Christ. By grace ye are saved. It took the blood of Jesus to deliver us. It took Jesus Christ's blood, blood like no other, not like the animals, but blood like no other. It was Jesus Christ's blood. Hebrews, the 9th chapter, verses 13 through 22, it says, "For if the blood of bulls and of goats and the ashes of an heifer sprinkling unclean sanctified to the purifying of the flesh, how much more shall the blood of Christ, who through eternal spirit offered himself without spot to God, purge your conscience from dead works to serve the living God? And for this cause he is the mediator of the New Testament, that by means of death for the redemption of transgressions that were under the First Testament, they which are called might receive the promise of eternal inheritance. For where a testament is, there must also be necessity of death of the testator. For a testament is of force after men are dead. Otherwise, it is no strength at all while the testator liveth. Whereupon neither he first testament was dedicated without blood. For when Moses had spoken every precept to the people according to the law, he took the blood of calves and of goats with water and scarlet wool and hyssop and sprinkled both the book and all the people, saying, this is the blood of the testament which God had enjoined unto you. Moreover, he sprinkled with blood both the tabernacle and the vessels of the ministry. And almost all things are by the law purged with blood. And without shedding of blood is no remission." We need the blood. And we need the blood of Jesus. Not the blood of animals and goats and bullocks and things like that. But we need the blood of Jesus. And the Bible says that when he did it, he said that for when Moses had spoken every precept to the people according to the law, he took the blood of calves and of goats with water. We need the water. We need the water. In Hebrews, it talks about, for it's not possible that the blood of bulls and goats should take away sins. We need the blood of Jesus. Titus 2 and 14 says, "Who gave himself for us, that he might redeem us from all iniquity." Thank you, Jesus, for the blood. "And purify unto himself a peculiar people." Thank you, Jesus, for the blood. "Zealous of good works." Thank you, Jesus, for the blood. 1 Corinthians 6 says, "We are washed, we are sanctified, we are justified in the name of the Lord Jesus and by the Spirit of our God." 1 Peter 2 and 9 says, "But ye are a chosen generation." Thank you, Lord Jesus, for the blood. "A royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, that ye should show forth the praises of him who hath called you out of darkness into his marvelous light." Thank you, Jesus, for the blood. Jesus can free us wherever we are. Remember, Paul was on the road to Damascus, and he got freed. The prodigal son was in the field with the pigs, and he got free. One woman was drawing water from a well, and she got free. Another woman caught in adultery, but she got free. Leading us out of Egypt, just like he did the children of Egypt. Freedom, freedom. And he heard our cries, and he know our sorrows. "Stand fast, therefore, in the liberty wherewith Christ hath made us free. And be not entangled again with the yoke of bondage." The Bible tells us Moses stretched forth his hand over the sea. Freedom. I can imagine in my mind that when Moses got to the Red Sea and he saw the people behind him, Pharaoh and his chariots behind, and he saw the Red Sea in front, I can imagine in my mind how when he stretched out what he had in his hand, when he stretched out the rod and the sea began to part, I can imagine he said, "Freedom, freedom, I can imagine. He said, I don't have to see this no more. I don't have to be in it. We don't have to live this in sin no more. We have been brought to freedom. I can imagine Moses saying that. And the Bible says, and when they crossed over, Moses and the children of Israel sang a song, and Miriam took a timbrel, and the women with timbrels and dancing, for he has triumphed gloriously. Our God only knows how to triumph. Even when things look miserable and desperate, rushing out of Egypt, there came a time to celebrate and to sing and dance. He did it all for me and you. He did it all for me and you. He did it all for us. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief, and he hid as it were our faces from him. He was despised, and we esteemed him not. Surely he hath borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgression. He was bruised for all our iniquities. The chastisement of his peace was upon him, of our peace was upon him. And with his stripes we are healed. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. All we are like sheep gone astray, have turned everyone to his own way. And the Lord had laid on him the iniquity of us all. Went our own way, did our own thing. But he paid the price for us. He died for us. He bled for us. His own blood, the blood of Jesus that could take away the sin of the world. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He is brought as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before the shearers is dumb, so he opened not his mouth. All but the blood of Jesus. He was taken from prison and from judgment. And who shall declare his generation? For he was cut off out of the land of the living. Oh, but the blood of Jesus. For the transgression of my people he was stricken. He did it all for me. He did it all for you. Oh, but the blood of Jesus that can take away my sins. And he made his grave with the wicked and with the rich in his death, because he had none done no violence. Neither was any deceit in his mouth. Yet it pleased the Lord to bruise him. Accept your freedom. Accept your freedom. Passover may not be the same as what we're used to, but Passover has not changed. We might not be able to worship together right now, but our worship has not changed. Our praise may not be in the sanctuary, but our praise has not changed. Yes, our Redeemer lives. Our Redeemer lives. And let the redeemed of the Lord say so. In the book of John, it says that they sought to take him, but no man laid their hands on him, because his hour was yet not come. And when they went to the officers, they were confused, and they asked, "Why haven't you brought him to us?" And the officer said, "Never a man spake like this man. Never a man spake like this man." They couldn't even find no fault in him. Then they answered and they said, "Are you deceived? Never a man spake like this man." Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things into his hands, that he was come from God and went to God. Our Redeemer lives. Our Redeemer lives. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so, whom he hath redeemed from the hand of the enemy. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Our Redeemer liveth, and he did it all for us, saints. He did it for us. Shed his blood. He didn't have no iniquity. He didn't have no sin. He did it for us that we might live. For it is not possible but the blood of bulls and goats should take away sins. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Who can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. He was beaten and spit on, mocked, whipped. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Lord, I thank you for the blood of Jesus. Accept your freedom. Accept your freedom. Accept your freedom and live. You're a chosen generation. You are a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people. And show forth the praises of him who hath called you out of darkness unto the marvelous light. Don't look back, move forward. Don't look back, move forward. This month shall be unto you the beginning of months. It shall be the first month of the year to you. Accept your freedom and live. This is the beginning of months for us. And let it be a beginning of changes in our lives. Let it be a new beginning of changes in our lives. New commitments to do better and be better than what I've been before. Let it be a change. Let our freedom come. Let us have freedom and live. He died for us, shed his blood for us, that we may not live. Lord, thank you for the blood that will never lose its power. The blood that reaches to the highest mountain and flows through the lowest valley. God bless you. Happy Passover, saints. But don't be discouraged. We are in a feast of a joyous feast. This is the Lord's Passover. It is Passover, and his blood can reach us anywhere. Anywhere we are, he died for us. Not just for us, but for the sin of the whole world. And he did it all for us. He did it all for me. He did it all for you. Accept your freedom. He suffered and died for you. He suffered and died for me. Accept your freedom. The Lord bless thee and keep thee. The Lord make his face shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and give thee peace. As often as ye do eat this bread and drink this cup, ye do show forth the Lord's death till he come. God bless you. He did it all for us. He did it all for me. He did it all for you. What can take away our sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. We thank you, saints. Enjoy. Happy Passover. Happy Passover. And I know it was a happy Passover in our homes tonight. I know that we gave thanks and honor to God for all that he has done. He's been good. Yet another year, he has kept us to be able to celebrate this season, this appointed time, yet another year. And Lord, we thank you. Yet another year. We found grace. Yet another year. And we thank you, Lord. We thank you. Nothing but your blood. Nothing but your blood to save a wretch like me. Cleanse my mind and my conscience. Give me a new heart. Create in me a new heart. A new creature. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. He gave us a heart of flesh. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. And we will serve him. We will magnify him. We will praise him. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. When I see the blood. When I see the blood. When I see the blood. I will pass over you. God bless you, saints. I love you. Happy Passover.